First Baptist Church, Tullahoma. I wanted to talk with you today because after much prayer, after much consideration and counsel, I've come to the conclusion that it's going to be best for us to do like virtually every other church that I know of, and temporarily, at least for the coming weeks, maybe the next month or two, depending on how things play out with this sickness, it's going to be in our best interest and in your best interest to stop all on-campus activity. We'd already canceled our midweek and Sunday afternoon, Sunday evening activities, and we're hoping to be able to meet through the end of March, but based on the prayers, the consideration, the counsel that I've been given, I think it's going to be best for us to go ahead and follow suit with most of the other churches and postpone our weekly gatherings. Now, what pushed me over the edge was I had to come to the conclusion that I could live with 14 days from now. And 14 days from now, after this illness has been in incubation, after it's been dormant, and yet people have been contagious, 14 days from now, if we find out that many of our people were infected because we met, I can't live with that. 14 days from now, if we find out that I overreacted and we could have met, I can live with that. So that's kind of how I came to this ultimate conclusion today on Thursday to say that we would postpone meeting together. Now, there's some bad news in that. The bad news is, up until this point, there was some numerical momentum in our church. We were seeing on average more than 400 people in our worship services. And now that momentum is going to be hit because of this illness. We were seeing financial momentum. You had given more financially to this church than you'd given in its history. You gave more to Lottie Moon than you've ever given. We are giving more to missions than we have ever given. And obviously that momentum is going to stall due to this illness. We'd seen missional momentum. We had mission trips planned throughout the year. We just got a team back from North Africa. We had a team set to go to New York in April. We had a team set to go to Southeast Asia in June. We were forming a team to go to Germany in July, August. We have another team set for North Africa in September that's already beginning to form. Another team to New York that's already almost filled up for October. And then another trip to Germany in December, along with a few other trips that are closer by. And all of that's kind of been put on hold for the time being. And the concern is that we lose missional momentum during this time. And those are just the realities. But the stronger reality that I'm holding on to and that I want to challenge you and encourage you to hold on to is the reality that our God is sovereign. And as we were planning all of these things, as we were celebrating all of these things in January, February, God was sitting on the throne and he said, things are going to change in March. Our God is sovereign. This is not taking him by surprise. It's not shocked him. It's not surprised him in any way. And he's not only sovereign, but he's good. And we can rest in the fact that God is, yes, in control, and that, yes, God is working everything together for good to those who love him and are called according to his purpose. So we know without a shadow of a doubt that regardless of all of the shifts and changes and twists and turns that seem to happen daily as we navigate the waters of a pandemic, we know that in the end, God is in control and God is going to work things out that we can't even imagine. He's going to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we could ever ask or imagine. He is good. Now, as we think about the reality that we won't be gathering here in this building for the next several weeks, we'll take this a week at a time, day by day. We'll keep you updated. As we think about that, I want you to know that we are not, as a church, hitting the pause button. Okay, we're not going to go into intermission, just go home, kick our feet up, and wait on this thing to pass, and then try to all come back together. We need to be very, very proactive. And here's what I want to call you to do. I want to call you to do several things. I want you to pay close attention. I know this is a longer video than normal, but I want you to pay close attention. Number one, we're going to worship. Okay, and here's how we're going to worship. I want to encourage you, if at all possible, to plan to be here on campus Sundays at 11 o'clock. Now you're thinking, you just said we're not going to meet corporately. We've got to do this social distancing thing. How are we going to meet on Sunday? Well, we're going to do something kind of novel. We're going to do something that we believe is creative and that can give us some level of fellowship, some level of community. We're going to do a drive-in style church service in Fountain Park. We're going to have a platform set up. We're going to have worship. We're going to have preaching. You're going to pull your vehicles into the parking lot by the ministry center, the parking lot, the parking places off of Grundy if necessary. We're going to pull into that parking lot. We're going to back in. We're going to sit in our vehicles. You'll be able to listen live to the speakers. We're going to work on being able to tune you into an FM station if you can't hear the speakers clearly. You can pull your lawn chairs out and sit at the back of your vehicle and tailgate if you would like and wave at your neighbor. And be present for outdoor worship, be present for outdoor preaching live on the scene at 11 o'clock. So there'll be no 8:30, no Sunday school, 11 o'clock drive-in church. If at all possible, we want to ask you to come to drive-in church at 11 o'clock Sunday. If that's not possible for you, the second option, the second most favorable option, we want to ask you to invite some people that you're comfortable with. Maybe some of your extended family, maybe some of your neighbors to your house, maybe inside, if you're not comfortable inside, gather on the porch, gather under a tree, and live stream the service as a group. Sing together, pray together, listen to the message together with other believers that are in your area that you're comfortable gathering with. And if you do that, we want to ask you to be sure you comment on the Facebook Live post. Make sure you share that so others in our congregation can find it. We need your help and getting the word out during these days of online worship and online preaching. So we want to encourage you. Think about who you can invite to your home. If you can't come to drive-in church at 11, who can you bring into your home, to your house, under the oak tree in the yard to worship with together? If you can't do that, if you can't come to drive-in church, you can't gather up with another family or two or a few other friends to worship together, then obviously we want you to tune in live stream or Facebook Live and watch the service there and join us online there. And if you do that, again, we want to ask you to be sure to share that post. We want to ask you to comment. Let us know you're there so that we know you're watching, so that we know that you're engaged. That's how we're going to worship until further notice. Again, we're taking this a week at a time. There may be technological difficulties. There may be hiccups. If there are hiccups, if there's technological difficulties, we will get you the sermon somehow, some way. Bear with us as we're in this learning curve together. Worship, 11 o'clock drive-in church, if possible, Ministry Center parking lot, Fountain Park. Bring your lawn chairs, sit on your tailgate, sit in your vehicle. If you can't do that, invite some people to your home, invite some people to your yard, worship together in a small group. If you can't do that, make sure you log on personally or as a family. Let us know you're there, share the post, and worship together this Sunday. Second thing is obviously giving. We want to remind you that you can give. We'll take up an offering at drive-in church. If you're meeting with other people in your home, gather up offerings. You can bring it up here and drop it off at the church. You can mail your check. You can drop off your check to the office in the box outside, or obviously you can give online via the church app or the church website. Click the heart on the app, click give on the website, and it'll explain to you how you can continue to give faithfully so that we can continue to get the gospel to the ends of the earth and to support missionaries and to do the work that we do as a church. Thirdly, fellowship and disciple making. I want to talk to you briefly about fellowship and disciple making during this time when we're not able to meet as Sunday school classes. Maybe you're not able to meet as small groups, as D groups. If you're a deacon, I'm calling on you to be very proactive, very self-motivated, very careful to contact your families very, very regularly during this time. Check in on them, pray with them, see how they're doing, keep up with them. We need you to be the shepherds of your families. We need you to be the servants of these families during this time. So deacons, step up. If you're a Sunday school teacher, I'm asking you to step up. Think about those people in your Sunday school class. Contact them regularly. Reach out to them regularly. Pray for them regularly. Find out their needs regularly. And listen, Sunday school class, if you want to meet, we want to challenge you, we want to encourage you to please, please consider meeting as a Sunday school class. If you can't do that in person, then please consider meeting as a Sunday school class via FaceTime. There's an app called Zoom that a lot of people are using. If you want to use that for your Sunday school class, dozens of people can log in. They can all be present for the teaching. They can all communicate back and forth. If you need help with that, call the church office. We can get you a video to help you. We can set up a time for you to come in and talk to Brett McNew. He can help you set that up. Don't waste these days. Don't hit the pause button. Don't pretend this is intermission. If you're a Sunday school teacher, reach out to your students, reach out to your classes, and then try to get together through Zoom, FaceTime, or some other avenue to teach, to be engaged together. If you're a D group leader, now is the time to rise up and shine as a D group leader. Make sure you are keeping up with your D group members. Most D groups are 3 to 5 people. You can meet 6 feet apart. My group met this morning. This is how we're going to stay connected during this time. So please, D group leaders, deacons, Sunday school teachers, everybody step up and minister as much as possible. As we think about fellowship and disciple making, it is critical, critical, critical that you keep up with our plus one challenge and initiative. You've got to be a self-feeder during this time. You've got to be a self-feeder. Go to plusonechallenge.com, review those challenges, re-up, recommit, take those challenges, seek to draw one step closer to Jesus. Don't miss the plus one app. On the app, the prayer guide. Please, that's going to be updated each week. Get that prayer guide and pray, pray, pray for our plus one challenge, for our plus one prayer guide. Look for those helps videos. Share them, and share them, and watch them, and hopefully they will encourage you. The staff's going to be doing videos. Michael's going to do some videos for kids. Brett's going to be doing Zoom meetings with youth. He's going to do some teaching videos. As we are able, we're going to share those videos, spread them out among the church, and let's stay connected as we seek to fellowship as best we can and as we seek to make disciples. Now, I want to talk about prayer is important during this time. We're sending out app reminders, Facebook reminders to pray. We're going to continue doing that to guide you and encourage you to pray during this time of challenge in our country. We're going to keep the plus one prayer guide updated. Go to the church app, go to the church website, watch that, download it, look at it each week, and pray together as a church. And then make sure if you haven't downloaded the church app, you do that. Watch the church app. That's where you're going to get announcements, notifications. Watch the church Facebook page. Watch the church website. And we're going to do the best we can as your leaders to shepherd you through this time well. As we think about this reality, we know that it's going to come to an end. There's going to be a day when this is over and we return to a new normal. And we're already thinking about, we're already praying about, and we're already planning for that day. And that day is going to be back to church Sunday, and it's going to be great. It's going to be big. We're planning for it right now. We want to see everyone come back. We want to see everyone invite their neighbors and everybody they've engaged during this time. We want to invite the community to come back out in the public, back to church, to worship the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And we're going to be amazed when we see what God has done through this time. Thank you for your faithfulness. Thank you for your patience with us as we try to lead during this time. We're going to be putting out other videos, reminders, make sure you know what's going on. So bear with us, share the word, spread the word, and most importantly, pray for us. And we hope to see you Sunday at Drive-In Church 11, and if not there, on Facebook Live or live stream.